child, he don't pronounce my name correct. Rules have gotta be. And I'm not a leader. Think in the box and I get him. I fix the shot as if I need a donor hole. He'll get to the crib and quickly. I wipe my mouth when I finish watching y'all suck cock. Don't doubt you put an ounce of that evil on. I give an inch to you simps. I'll never forgive me. No saying it's a conspiracy, but you're all against me. You see a future with runner jewels. Ain't this ever cancel my.
Say that you don't love me, ay. I'm guessing I'ma be okay. You say that you don't feel me now. I feel like I'ma live so.
MLB The Show is at the gateway to the West, St. Louis, Missouri, and lovely Busch Stadium. Today, it's the finale of this four-game set between the Phillies and the St. Louis Cardinals. Kwang Hyun Kim gets the start for St. Louis in this one. Dan, any thoughts?
Hey, Matt, we're getting a look at a guy that's really been struggling lately. In his last three starts, he has a whip of over 1.50. Lots of base runners, lots of hits, and lots of walks, and that doesn't add up to very good performances. So he's going to look to turn things around in this one here today.
Stepping up is Willy Castro as we take a look at the splits between April and May. Now the pitch. They set the target in, and this finds the inside. Hero, we take a look at this Cardinals ball club as they enter play this afternoon. They come in not exactly setting the world on fire as they've dropped five of their last eight ball games.
Yeah, Matt, if it hasn't been the best of times, D-Row. They've lost the first three games of this set at home, and the last thing you want to do is get swept in a four-game series at home. You need to win this one.
Yeah, it can't happen. Can't get swept four games in a row on your home turf. Watch for the manager to make. He's going to make moves, and he's going to make them quick. I don't know what they're going to be pitching, hit and run. Something's happening today.
So now into the box is Joaquin Diaz. Comes in 0-for-9 in the series so far, so looking to turn things around in this one. Hit on the ground out to short. First, and a quick start to the afternoon. Two away. And that brings up Javi Baez. First chance for him here in the top of the first with nobody on. And now a pitch on the way. First pitch fastball swung on and missed 0-1.
If the offense didn't already know, man on the mound's got his A-game fastball working today.
Hard on the ground towards short. DeYoung's got it. Off balance throw gets him. Nice play there as the side is retired. In the hole, falling away. That is pure magic. Back with more of this Thursday afternoon business person special following this. Connecticut will be doing the pitching in this one. What's your take on him, Dan?
Hey, it wasn't a great performance in his last start, but he did pitch well enough to earn the win. A little bit better performance in this one.
Now at the plate here is Tommy Edman. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. And now a pitch hit sharply on the ground. But a foul ball here, 0-1. ripped on the ground to first. And he'll take it to the bag himself for the out.
Batting second, the center fielder, Blaine Thomas.
Digging in will be Blaine Thomas. Here's the first pitch to him.
Nope, that's a ball.
Dan Dero, as we take a look at our visiting club as they take the field in this scoreless ball game. Fortune has been smiling on them recently. They're unbeaten in their last seven games.
You know, Matty, the season's such a grind, and you fight so hard day in, day out, and you're playing against the best players in the world, so you know you're going to lose some games coming out of spring training. To get on a roll where you win seven in a row, a week of everything coming together, that's a special feeling.
Now time to list the umpires in this one. Behind the plate is Jerry Hillsdale.
You know, D-Row, I think Jerry Hillsdale is a very good hitter's umpire. Doesn't give much on the edges. He's going to make you put the ball over the plate.
Oh, I love me some.
Could be. 3-1 to him now. Hitters count all the way. Here it comes.
Yeah.
Bases are empty. One man out. This is going to find its way into left for a one-out knock.
Hey, the leadoff man wasn't able to do his job, but the number two hitter came through right there with the single, setting the table for the big
one.
And that'll bring in Nolan Arenado, as the first pitch to him is in there for a called strike one. Civale has a reputation as a strike thrower, although that doesn't often result in a ton of strikeouts. A typical start may find him with a low walk total and the ball in play a lot.
Matty, he's what they...
And hold on there. He got him. Trying to swipe second base, but he's gunned down for the out. Two out, nobody on. And they'll try to bounce a curveball on 0-2, but he holds back. It's 1-2 now. Arenado swings, and this one is crushed out to left field. And that one is gone on a two-strike count with two away in the inning. Nolan Arenado touches them all. 12 home runs for him now thus far, and the Cardinals move out in front 1-0.
Yeah, we always talk about how important it is to spot your starter or run it to early in the game, and he does just that, blasting a no-doubt bomb that serves notice. They're going to be swinging with the wood here. No better way to get the home crowd into it right out of the gates.
And that brings up Paul Goldschmidt.
The first baseman.
As the first pitch misses to him, it's ball one. He'll start play with that average down in the low 230s. 11 home runs and 22 RBIs. Well outside with the curveball for a ball.
Like to see him be looking to the opposite field with this next swing. Pitcher's trying to work you away.
Down low, and the plot thickens here, 3-0.
I'd be shocked if this wasn't a four-pitch walk right here. He doesn't want to mess around and leave something over the heart of the plate and get beat in this situation.
And he'll just watch the cut fastball here for strike one, 3-1. And the count will be full. Swing and a ball hard hit toward deep right. Harper finds some space out there for the catch to retire the shot. One scores in the inning coming on this solo home run. Second inning coming up, and the Redbirds have an early 1-0 advantage. it'll be the four-hole hitter, Bryce Harper. He'll get us started in the top of the second.
Bryce Harper.
And now the first pitch. A ball and no strikes. Well, today's game provides the visiting squad with a chance to complete the series sweep, guys.
You might start to call these guys the Road Warriors. It's hard to win on the road, and with a win today, they would complete a sweep of a four-game set on the road.
2-0 now. Now here's the pitch. Too high, and it's 3-0. Of course, in order to achieve said sweep, they'll need to overcome this early one-run deficit.
When you're playing as well as this team is right now, they've got them right where they want them. They're only down one early in this one, and when you've won a couple of games in a row already, you have that feeling you can certainly come back and win this one.
You maybe get two pitches a game where all the guesswork goes out the window. This is certainly that situation.
And he fouls this one off. Now the payoff pitch home. And that misses for ball four. So it's a leadoff walk here to start the second.
Well, the reason power hitters generally draw more walks than other guys is exactly what we saw right there. Pitchers work around them and nibble the corners a lot more so they don't get burned. He made some good pitches, but he just couldn't get him to chase enough out of the zone.
Giancarlo Stanton now, and he's been tearing the cover off the ball these past few days, as you see there. Ready with the first pitch, here it comes. And this one's down off the shoe tops, 1-0. Check swing, no swing, says the home plate umpire, ball two. Fouled off. Harper on at first, nobody out. Well behind that fastball, it's a swinging strike. And that misses, so it's a full count, 3-2.
Looked like he tried to elevate a fastball on that 2-2 pitch there, but kind of overdid it. With a pitch that high, it's pretty easy to lay off if you're the hitter.
And boy, that misses to start out the inning.
We knew coming into this game that this guy has a tendency to give up a lot of free passes, and history repeats itself as he's already given up two walks here. I'll tell you, effectively wild is a pretty tough thing to be.
So stepping in is Keston Hiura. A base knock to the outfield could score the tying run from second. He comes set. Here's the nothing and nothing pitch. Now a ball grounded to short. This could be two. The double play.
Oh, that's a rally killer right there. They were in great shape with two on and nobody out, but the double play is the last thing you want in that situation. Just a runner at third now, but there's two outs.
Standing in now, JT Realmuto has the first pitch to ball 1-0. He'll start this one at 274. Six home runs and 15 RBIs. Two balls and no strikes.
Now 2-0 with a great hitter up, a runner on third and two outs. This is not the spot where you want to be challenging a hitter like this. This is where you have to pitch very careful.
The set and the 2-0 line to left, and that'll get by and on through towards the wall. He's in at second safely as a run comes across to score on the play, tying the ball game.
Yeah, it's always nice to get a run right back after you've given one up to the guys in the other dugout. So he squares this thing up really well to drive in a run and ties us up at one.
And that'll bring up the Sacramento product, Rhys Hoskins. Throw cleanly into first, and that ends the inning. But a run will score in the inning on this RBI double. We'll go to the bottom of the second, all even at one apiece. Ready to go for the last half of the inning, and that'll bring forth the slugging shortstop, Paul DeJong. First offering. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Swings through it for strike number two. And a good take there. Close, but it's 2-2. This one's down to third. Baez fields it cleanly. Throw on to first in time, one away.
Batting trip. The left fielder. Gillen. Carlson.
Up next, Dylan Carlson is back in the starting lineup for this one after sitting out last night's game. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes.
That's a ball.
The windup and the 1-0 pitch. Hard on the ground towards short. And he whiffs on it as this ball's right under his glove. Throw into second, and he is in there.
Yeah, I'm not sure. This ball might have caught him in between hops. He looked unsure which way to turn his glove, and the next thing you know, it's by him.
To the plate now, Hernan Perez. This will take a look at a slider here that finds the zone for strike one. He comes in with that average down in the 240s. Two home runs and a dozen RBIs. Here's the 0-1.
Wow, not sure what you're looking for right there, but that one was pretty much middle center cut. Tough pitch to take.
Inside, as that perhaps will back him off a bit. 1-2. And the slider gets him swinging. Two gone.
Classic slider down and away for the strikeout there. Not a whole lot to say about that pitch that hasn't been said a million times already. That's just a real tough pitch for a hitter to pick up out of a pitcher's hand. So they end up chasing when they're in protect mode.
Stepping in now, MJ Melendez. Early swing there as he pulls it foul to the right side. Runner in scoring position with two gone. Comes set, the 0-1.
On 0-2 here, he doesn't have to give in with a great pitch to hit. He's got a base open. So he.
Oh, and he has some trouble with it. Chalk that one up as an E6, and he really can't believe it out there. The next to bat for St. Louis, Kwang Hyun Kim, and their runners at the corners now. From the belt, kicks and deals. Curveball just misses, apparently, 1-0.
Man, 35 pitches with only two outs in the second inning. Ideally, you'd like to have 30 or less after two innings, so he's got some catching up to do.
A ball and a strike.
Hey, as a former infielder, nothing hurts your heart more than making errors behind your pitchers. Let's see if this guy can pick him up right here.
Ready with the 1-2. And the cutter got him swinging. Strike three, and the side is retired. Cards strand a couple. Through two, we're tied one apiece. Now at the plate is Aaron Civale, as we are all set to begin the third inning in this one.
Aaron Civale.
First pitch of the AB now. And he throws the fastball by him here, 0-1.
Well, he kind of tipped his hand right there. His approach is obviously sitting on the off speed because he was so late on that first pitch heater.
A ball and a strike now. Taken, called strike two on the inside part of the plate, 1-2 now. Looked like the fastball got away from him there. It's ball two.
I know he missed with a fastball right there, but this guy's arsenal, you can't figure out what he's trying to do. He's got a lot of different directions he could go in right here.
Swing and a miss on the fastball, and that's the first out.
Boy, that's the best pitch in baseball right there with two strikes, that elevated fastball. Every hitter thinks that, hey, they can do something with that, but most of the time, you get the result that you saw right there, a big swing and a miss and another strikeout.
Into the box now, Willie Castro. And he popped him up. Goldschmidt in foul ground, two gone. Now to bat, Joaquin Dias grounded out in his last at bat.
Yeah, I understand that, Matty, but this guy's got burner wheels down the first baseline. I don't think he even concerns himself with that. He has to put it on the ground. That's part of what makes him successful.
The 0-1 delivery.
Hey, with two outs in the number two hole, you're just trying to get on. You got the big boys coming up behind you.
The windup and the 0-2 pitch. And this one runs in on him as he can't get his arms extended. A great pitch there, and the inning is over.